Hi everyone, welcome to Stunner Share. So in this video we're going to see the post market analysis. So come, let's move on to this video. So nothing much to say, to be very honest. It was a huge gap down and then market completely went down, so not able to do anything with respect to Nifty today. But I was able to predict the bearishness in Nifty as well as in Bank Nifty on Friday itself. I posted several scenarios of bearishness, what it was showing, and clearly that bearishness happened today. So if you wanted to know what is that bearishness which I told and all those things, kindly check my Telegram channel or check the YouTube channel, so that I have posted the video on yesterday about the market analysis. So you can understand what has actually happened in Nifty and Bank Nifty. Clear? So now let me come to the post which I have shared in Twitter. So in the morning I told Nifty is opening with a huge gap down of 170 points. So 13 July is a virgin CPI zone. I am expecting Nifty to take support over there. Let's hope Nifty does not touch 15650. If that's touch, I'll be turning neutral bias. Disclaimer applicable. So the bias for now is bullish only. I'm not yet turned into bearish or a neutral bias. So my point is I would wait for this zone to breach. If this zone is breached, 15,632 is breached, okay, any tick, maybe in 5 minutes, 1 minute, no matter, if it is touch, then my bias will turn into obviously a neutral bias. Because why am I saying it as neutral bias is I will be expecting Nifty to go and give a close below 15,450 and then only my bias will turn into bearish. So till that time it will be in a range bound scenario only, okay? And once this zone is broken, I'll be neutral. So I might expect some support from here and Nifty going up here, taking support. All these can happen in Nifty. Clear? So now again coming to the what I said about the virgin CPR is, so I told this particular day the virgin CPR is there because the candles did not touch the CPR. So I was expecting Nifty to take a support over here, but it took a support over here, a small gap zone. It took a support over here and started moving up. And then what I posted is Nifty can face resistance at 15th July 2021 virgin CPR zone. So either we need to close above it or we might face some resistance at that zone. Clear? And then we might again come down. That is what I said. I said it around 9:31 itself because this candle went and stopped over there. And here is the virgin CPR zone, another virgin CPR zone. So this virgin CPR zone also, I was expecting some resistance to happen. So if we have to turn into bullish, what I told is we have to close above this zone and then take support over here. When a resistance is converted to a support, that will be treated as a bullishness. But here, initially for these 2 days, it was a support and now it became a resistance. So the bearishness will come and we might see downside only, I told. And now we are at the one more virgin CPR zone, that is nothing but over here. Clear? So my understanding is we are at a good support zone and we are nearly at this zone. So to be very honest, I'm expecting some support to be taken here itself, because I could see some support over here. So I'm expecting some support to be taken. If you are not going to give a good support, then it is bit worry only. Let us see how market is going to turn out. But as far as I checked HDX Nifty and the global markets, it is bit weak. Because if you see over here, I go to indices futures. If you see, the low formed is 15,643 and we are at 15,681. And today we closed at 15,757. And almost it looks we are nearly 70 points down only. Okay. And then all other markets are down. See, S&P 500, Nasdaq, all 1.4%, 2% down. And even Europe was down 2%, 3% down, because Europe is facing some flood situations as well. So that might be some reasons. And even Asian market is also down. All the Asian markets, Singapore markets, all those are also down. So I'm not able to justify this more bearishness, because technically speaking, it was a false breakout and then we are coming down. Okay, that's fine. But what is the news or what is the bad thing which is happening and that is making the market, our market, to come down? I'm not sure. Okay, because see, the situation is different. Europe is facing flood situations, so that's they are falling. US is facing some COVID situation, they are falling. And Asian market, some of the other reason. Even Malaysia is facing some COVID and all those things, so they might come down. And even in Tokyo, the Olympic Games is going on, and there are few cases which were found, and that is why it can come down. That is fine. But what happened to India? India, it is like we had like COVID second wave, and then we recovered. So ultimately, we should not fall, right? And when we were falling here in these zones, like we were falling in these zones, at that time global markets were not falling. So we were not falling. We were not following global markets for some time. But as far as intraday moves, I was able to predict this fall because of prior analysis as well as the CPR virgins, CPR zones, and all those. That gave a clear indication of today's fall as well as predicting the today's fall on Friday itself. So all these things helped. But ultimately, I don't see any bad reasons to fall. And even maybe one of the reason what I would like to convince myself is like HDFC Bank results. It is not good. It is good, but not below the estimates. So that is why it had fallen. Maybe that might be the reason. But if it is still continuing tomorrow, then that is where I am like confused, like why this much we have to fall. So ultimately, my point will be like we might take some support at this zone, and that is what my expectation. So let us see how market is going to happen. And even if you see in the previous week videos, I told clearly that we have to fill this gap. I told this, right? And we are almost filled, and we have not filled completely. Clear. So the high of this candle is around 15,702.5, and this low is 15,707. So 5 points still gap has to be filled. So that might be the reason tomorrow we might expect a gap down and then move upside only. And that is what my expectation. And tomorrow, if we are moving upside, this zone will act as some resistance. Clear? We might gap down, we might open over here, and we might go over here, and we might face some resistance over here. Clear? So with respect to CPR, with respect to Camarilla, both will be like lower value relationship only, and both are showing bearish price only. So we need to check how the market is opening, and based on that only we'll be able to decide what is going to happen. Clear? And the same analysis for Bank Nifty. Bank Nifty, I clearly told this will be one zone we need to watch out, and I was expecting the market to come over this zone, and market ultimately came over this zone. But again, if you see, market is slightly trying to move down only. So ultimately, this should be the zone where Bank Nifty needs to take some support. If Bank Nifty is missing here, and it might again fall another 1,200 points or 1,000 points, so that is a bit worrying situation only. And even if you guys see the option chain analysis, they are giving clear indication. Let me show that one sec. So option chain for Nifty, forget about current week expiry. On month expiry, if you see, I was telling like 16,000 was acting as a good resistance for a longer time. This was having a highest OA contract, and this was facing some good resistance. And in the put side, though we were trading at 15,800, 900, still 15,000 is having the highest OA. So that clearly showed that no matter if we trade at 15,995 also, our support is going to be at 15,000 only, and we are going to ride that only, and we are expecting the July month to trade between that only. So this clearly showed that something is happening, something is cooking up. And even if you see Bank Nifty, I clearly told that 35,500 call option was written. That was an ITM call option. So we might need to expect some fall. So clearly that indicated. My only worry is why I did not see this before 3:30. Friday 3:30. If I have seen that, even if you see in Bank Nifty for CPR, the candle closed below the CPR. Okay, this itself a bearishness. Okay, this itself a bearishness. It is struggling above the current day CPR itself. This itself a bearishness. So I noticed this, but I somehow missed this. But if I had noticed the ITM call option written thing, I would have at least taken a put option, or I would have at least like sold the 35,500 put call option itself. So ultimately 35,500 call option was trading at around 441 rupees, and now see, in a single day 343 rupees it has gone. These are some situations which are like very hard or very tough to digest. For me it's like very tough to digest. And even if you see what the monthly contract says, the highest OA contracts is around, is like 30,444 highest OA contracts is seen at 36,000. So this 36,000 is going to be acting as a good resistance. And at the support side, see, everything is very less only. Okay, and that is 20,186 contracts found at 34,000 PE. So this is going to act as a support. And we were trading at 35,700 or 900 on Friday. Clear? 35,900 I think on Friday, and ultimately we came down 800 points in single day itself, and now we are in between that. Exactly, we are between 34,000 and 36,000. So OA was suggesting that we are neutral only, we don't go very bullish. It was suggesting that I missed this, or somehow I don't know how, maybe these are some lessons learned situation. So these are bound to happen, right? So these are some lessons learned situation. So ultimately, this is what has happened for today. Clear? And tomorrow, very clear, 22, we are bearish. As per the OA data for this expiry, we are looking bearish. And again, if you see 35,000, ITM is having a huge OA. Huge OA and huge change in OA contract. So we are bearish only. Ultimately, we are bearish. And this 306 can further go down also. But if we are trying to take some support at this zone, then good. If you are going to further dag down, then Nifty is in a worrying situation only. And at the put side, again, this is acting as a support, but a support will turn into resistance. When the support is turning into a resistance, it will be a bearish opportunity only. So tomorrow also I am expecting some bearishness, but let's see. If suppose you are opening with a good gap down and then market trying to fill that gap and move up, anything is possible, right? So we will not able to correctly say that what is going to happen, but for now the data is bearish. Clear? And now let us see for Nifty as well. Nifty for current expiry option chain. So 15,800 is having a good way, and this will act as resistance. And here not much support, it's like we can go down further, right? So that is what it is saying, but 15,700 is acting as a good support. This might act as a good support. And if you also check over here, if you also check over here, 15,800 was initially acting as a good support. Okay, see, initially there was 40,000 contracts over here. So this was acting as a good support yesterday, but now this is acting as a good resistance. So that is like support turned into resistance, that is a bearishness. Clear? So this is what I wanted to share with respect to Nifty as well as Bank Nifty. We are not that bullish, we are slightly mildly bearish only, but my bias is still bullish until and unless we close below or we touch these 15,632, then I'll be turning into neutral bias. Only when the sideways complete zone is broken down, then only I'll be like turning into bearish. I would prefer we would better go for we would better go for some hedging position alone, not to think of anything else. And one more thing what I noticed in Nifty is, on a daily time frame I could see a wolf wave pattern, and that is a bit of a risky or a worrying situation as well. Let me show that as well. So so this is what I saw in Nifty, and if this is the case, we are happening already. It gave a breakout, looks like a failed breakout, now coming down. Ultimately we might come to this zone as well. Okay, we have to be very sure. And why I always concentrate on that 15,630 zone, it's like if you see over here, it has almost did not give a close below 15,675 zone. If we are again giving a close below 15,675 zone, then that is a bit of worrying situation only. Clear? we can consider this zone as well, 15,575 to 15,630. If we are giving a close below these two lines in a daily time frame, then we might enter some sort of bearish territory, because the market is like was in a sideways nature in a bullish trend. Now it might come slightly down, and if that is the case wherein Nifty is coming down, then we need to be very cautious at this zone. This might be the worst possible zone where we can see Nifty. Above this, if it is forming, Nifty will again go into consolidation between 15,300 to 14,191. This is also possible. Clear? So for now we will have both the views, bullish as well as bearish views, but for now SGX is Nifty, SGX Nifty is showing some bearishness, so we might expect a good gap down also. Let us see how market is opening tomorrow. Clear? So if you feel the content is good, kindly give a like, and if you have any queries, do let me know in the comment section. Please share this video to friends and family and support us. Thanks a lot. Stay tuned for more videos.